ऑर्गेनो मैग्नीशियम एंड ऑर्गेनो लिथियम कंपाउंड्स, दीज कंपाउंड्स आर ऑल्सो कॉल्ड ऑर्गेनो मेटालिक्स. इन फैक्ट द कंपाउंड और द ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड हैविंग कार्बन मेटल बॉन्ड, यू कैन सी हियर कार्बन मेटल बॉन्ड, आर कॉल्ड ऑर्गेनो मेटालिक्स. सो By using this definition, we can say organomagnesium and organolithium compounds are organometallic compounds or organometallic reagents. Here, I have given three very popular organometallics. One is RLI, means organolithium reagents. This is RMgX, which you know very well. This is organomagnesium reagent. This is also called Grignard reagent. Another is this RRCULI, means organo copper reagents. They are also called organo cuprates. Now see here, this R means not just alkyl group, it may be aromatic ring or aryl group, it may be allyl, it may be benzyl, or it may be sp2 hybridized, sp hybridized carbon, or sp3 hybridized carbon. So what is important? Important thing is there must be carbon metal bond. So, you can see some more examples I have given here. Sodium is a metal, and this is sodium ethoxide or sodium phenoxide or sodium carboxylate. This salt, they are also metal, but they are not considered as organometallics because when you see their structure, there is no carbon metal direct bonding. So, although these compounds having metal or metal ion, they are not considered as organometallics because there is no carbon metal bond. So what is important? Carbon metal bond should be there. Why this carbon metal bond is unique? That we'll discuss under the heading reactivity. Now see here, if carbon is attached to more electronegative atom like oxygen, nitrogen or halogen, this bond becomes polar because of more electronegativity difference, and this X is now becoming negative. That means more electron density is shifted towards X because of minus I effect, and this carbon is now bearing partial positive charge. So in fact, this is an electron deficient species. This is electron deficient species, or this is called electrophile. We'll call it as electrophile. It is called electrophile, or it is called again, this is again acidic. This proton is acidic because it is electron deficient. See here, but when we change this bond, this X with any metal, as metal are more electropositive, so the metal having less electronegative negativity than the carbon, then the trend is reversed. So this now electron density is moving toward the C, and this is more close to this carbon. Because of this is now having partial negative charge, and metal will have a partial positive charge, or a complete ionic bond will be there. So this bond is not a covalent bond. There is an ionic character or the completely ionic bond if that electronegativity difference is more. Now I have given here the list, which you can see as we move toward this side, electropositivity increasing, and you can see here, if electronegativity, electropositivity is more, the metal is more electropositive, this bond becomes ionic. And you can see here the nature of ionic bond. Here carbon having a pair of electron. That means this carbon is negative. If this carbon is negative, this is called carbanion. And this carbanion is now acting either as a nucleophile or a base, depending on the other species present in the reaction medium. So this carbanion is now acting as a nucleophile or a base. So you can see here, when we add metal, when we introduce metal in the organic compound, the polarity is reversed, and because of that the reactivity of this compound is also reversed. So we must remember that this carbanion can act as a nucleophile as well as base. So we have to utilize this property for certain reactions. So thank you.